I can confidently state that the most profoundly influential technology of this decade is artificial intelligence. From Google Now and Siri in your phones to product recommendations on Amazon are getting better and better with the help of AI. The days are not too far when the cars around us are going to drive themselves, and some intelligent application on a supercomputer is going to decide how this world functions. Behind all this impressive AI technology are deep neural networks, which are designed based on how human brain works. Our brain is made up of billions of neurons, which are in a continuous process of learning. Scientists modeled these neurons mathematically and connected them like this to form an artificial neural network. Then they developed methods to train these networks to learn very specific tasks, just like a little kid learns. These networks have proven to be extremely capable in tasks such as recognizing images, understanding speech, language processing, etc. But the next emerging topic is video understanding, where the goal is to interpret a video for real-life tasks such as self-driving cars, drones, surveillance cameras, etc. But the difficulty is that the videos are incredibly more complex compared to images, because videos are made up of multiple images and audio. So to process them, it takes a lot of time. But consider this. If the system in your self-driving car realizes that another car entered your lane 2 seconds after it actually did, you are in trouble. So real-life processing is extremely important. Given this background, our research here at Illinois focuses on two specific things. One is to build special-purpose chips, which are designed to do just this, which makes them fast and efficient. Another is to build new neural network models, which takes less time to process these videos. As a computer hardware enthusiast, my particular contribution is in coming up with novel ways to make these chips more efficient and faster. Our vision here is simple. We want to make this technology accessible to the masses. And the way to do it is to get these applications into mobile phones, which are in everyone's pocket. And the way to do it is to build these power-efficient chips so that they're more accessible, more affordable, and feasible in a handheld device. That way, we truly touch the lives of everyone. Thanks.